Hey there, Saturday night, I watched the film Blood Pressure.
Let's talk about it.
The film is a story of a quietly frustrated woman who finds her life changed when she starts receiving letters from a secret admirer bearing lavish gifts, but also strange instructions. The film was directed and co-written by Sean Garrity, who was born in Winnipeg, Manitoba. He's also done films such as Inertia, Lucid, and My Awkward Sexual Adventure. The film also includes lots of other great Canadian talent. The main actress was actually born and raised in Toronto, so she is literally in her element. What did I like about it? I liked that they were upfront about it taking place in Toronto. It was obviously filmed in Toronto, but I like how they actually mentioned the fact that it was in Toronto. Referenced a lot of Toronto things, a lot of Toronto streets, cities. You could see the TTC in the background. You could see familiar areas of Toronto. The one kid is like, "Mom, you gotta take me to my soccer practice in Newmarket." And you're like, "Oh, I know where that is." And then her other kid is like, "Mom, don't take the DVP during rush hour. We're never gonna make it on time. Mom." It's great. So Canadian points for you. I thought the main actress did a really good job. I thought she was a relatable character in kind of how she handled the weird situation of getting these mysterious notes from a secret admirer. And not only getting letters, but having strange instructions to go along with them. And at first they start off very basic, you know, put this in your window if you want to proceed, blah, blah, blah. But then they start to kind of gradually get more and more ridiculous, and kind of seeing her reaction to the letters and whether or not she wants to keep going along with it or whether she's in too deep now. You really get into the story and you're like, what's gonna happen if she stops doing it? And the person obviously is watching her the whole time. Like, they're giving really intense details about her life. Is it a he? Is it a she? Are they dangerous? Are they gonna kill her? Do they have bad intentions, good intentions? I was on the edge of my seat, but not literally, because I was on my couch. And that's just uncomfortable. A lot of her acting is also silent, so I think that brings kind of a new depth to what she's doing. Read someone's emotions and how they feel about a situation without being able to express it verbally, but you still can kind of tell what she's thinking and what she's feeling, whether she's nervous or excited or happy about the letter or feeling scared. So I just thought she did a really good job on that. Okay, so what I did not like about it, the main thing that I really grinded my gears on the topic of gears is that there was a texting and driving scene. I mean, come on. Technically, the film came out in 2012, so I don't know if it was exactly illegal then, but I'm sure it was frowned upon. And she's on the highway. I mean, that's just not safe. Don't be those people. Keep our roads safe for the children. Another part that stood out was there was this dialogue scene in the living room where the husband and wife were just talking, and there was some real shaky cam happening. I mean, I can appreciate a good shaky cam, and they do have their place, you know, action movies. But for a regular dialogue scene in a living room in a suburban house, it just seemed a little out of place. So that was a little bit distracting. I don't know which category this fits into, but I'm still sort of thinking on whether or not I liked the ending. I'm not completely sold on it. I mean, it had kind of different layers to it, so I think some of what they were doing worked, but maybe I also don't get it. I'm still thinking about it. Is it clever? Is it metaphorical? Was that last scene really necessary? Watch it to find out what I'm talking about. Oh yes, and it's on Netflix. Canadian Netflix, of course. Who would like this? I think anybody who likes a psychological drama or a regular drama or a thriller, but a low key. There's not really that much action. It's more of kind of a gradual build throughout the film, but it's also, you know, a very real story. Like, it's nothing kind of over the top. Gives them some credit for coming up with such an intense storyline that's kind of, you know, also real, which is pretty cool to accomplish on their part. Wrapping things up here, I liked it and I would recommend it to people. And if you have seen it and want to contribute to the conversation without giving anything away, let us know down below or watch it and then comment. Join us next Wednesday where we'll watch another Canadian film and then we'll talk about it.